It was Jim's birthday, and he had gotten a packet of 20 tin soldiers as his gift. As Jim began to play with his new toys, he noticed that one of the soldiers had just one leg. Despite the missing limb, the boy placed the one-legged soldier in the front lines, telling him that he must be the bravest of all the little soldiers. Jim loved his toys, but one thing he did not know was that at night, when he was asleep, they would come to life and talk to each other. Jim would often forget to put his one-legged tin soldier away and would leave him in all sorts of places around his room. One day, Jim left the soldier next to a pretty tin ballerina. A friendship was born between the two, and soon the little soldier fell in love with the ballerina. Though he was very brave, he did not have enough courage to declare his love for her. One day, Jim was playing with his tin soldier on the windowsill when his mother called him for supper. He told the soldier to stay there and guard his room from enemies until he got back. Jim had left his window open, and a thunderstorm was brewing. A strong wind shook the windows, and the little soldier fell from the windowsill onto the ground outside. It rained very hard, and soon there were big puddles everywhere. A group of boys who were returning from school noticed the little tin soldier on the ground. One of the boys picked the soldier up and put him in his pocket. On the other side of the street, the gutter was overflowing and the current was carrying a little paper boat. One of the boys said, "Let's put the little soldier in the boat and make him a sailor." And so they took out the tin soldier and placed him in the paper boat. The gutter flowed into a sewer, and the little boat was carried down the drain. The boat was soaked and about to sink, but the little soldier, who had faced far greater dangers in battle, was not afraid. The sewer flowed into the river, and the little boat overturned. The tin soldier sank to the bottom of the deep waters, but he was not worried that he was about to die. Instead, he was worried that he would never see his pretty ballerina again. Then, without warning, the little soldier was eaten up by a large fish. The fish never did get the chance to digest its meal because it was immediately caught in the net of a fisherman. The fisherman took his fish to be sold at the market. Meanwhile, the cook who worked at Jim's house was shopping at the market, and she saw the big fish at the fisherman's counter. She bought it, took it back to her kitchen, and when she cut it open to clean it, she was very surprised to find the little tin soldier. She showed Jim what she had found. Jim recognized his little lost soldier by its missing leg. Jim knew that the poor soldier must have gone through a lot of trouble since his fall off the windowsill, so he put the soldier above the fireplace to warm him up, right next to the ballerina. Destiny had reunited them, and the soldier and the ballerina were overjoyed to be together once again. The next afternoon, Jim was playing with a ball, and he accidentally threw it above the fireplace. The ballerina and the tin soldier fell into the flames below. Jim ran to get his mother before it was too late. The soldier and the ballerina had fallen so close to one another that their tin bases began to melt together. And just as it seemed that they were going to melt entirely, Jim and his mother plucked them out of the fire. The soldier and the ballerina were saved, but they were not the same as they had been. Their bases had melted together into the symbol of true love, a heart. They would never be separated again.